actually. This is indefinite integral. So indefinite integral and the antiderivative are the same concept, but with using the different notation we describe. Okay, I mean derivative of the capital F of x is small f of x, or let's say that one. Okay, that's okay. Derivative of the capital F of x is small f of x. So this implies capital F of x and more than capital F of x, so plus c, are antiderivatives. So by using the indefinite integral notation, we will say that the integral of the f of x, okay, the meaning of the dx is you integrate with respect to x variable, is capital F of x plus c, okay? So this is indefinite integral. Instead of the antiderivative, we will use the indefinite integral notation and the name, okay? So now, actually our aim is to calculate the antiderivative of the this quotient. But we will say indefinite integral, and in the following sections, we will use the indefinite integral concept, okay? So how we can evaluate this one? Let's solve. Actually, it seems very complex, but after arrangement, you can obtain the some simple case, simple form. So this is x to power 4 e to power x over x to power 4 minus 5 times x to power 3 over x to power 4 dx. So we will integrate this two function, integral of the e to power x minus 5 over x dx, okay? So this function, e to power x minus 5 over x function, and this quotient function are the same function if x is different than zero, but x cannot be zero because it is in the denominator. X to power 4 is in the denominator, okay? So we should evaluate this integral. So on the other hand, or in the other viewpoint, we should find the sum function whose derivative is this function, okay? So what we know, that let's recall those some concepts. This is also recall. So derivative of the e to power x is e to power x, we know. So this implies integral of the e to power x from right hand side equals e to power x from left side plus c. And we know x to power n plus 1 over n plus 1 derivative is x to power n. Okay, this is the first one, this is second one. In the lecture course, I gave this formulas. So this implies from right hand side, integral of the x to power n with respect to x equals x to power n plus 1 over n plus 1 plus c. Okay, but this is valid if n is different than minus 1. If n equals minus 1, derivative of the ln x is 1 over x. So this implies integral of the 1 over x dx is ln, actually for the absolute value of the ln x it is correct. So absolute value of the ln x plus c, because we don't know x is either negative or positive, but x is different than zero, we are sure. So let's turn back to our problem. By using the properties of the integral, actually all properties are obtained from the derivative fact, okay? The summation of the derivative is the derivatives of the summation, as you know. So by using this idea, we obtain a properties, okay? In the lecture course, again, I gave, but let's write here. One more recall. Properties. You can find the lecture records, quickly I will write, integral of the f of x plus g of x dx or differences equals integral of the f of x dx plus or minus integral of the g of x dx. And for the constant factors, some key times f of x dx integral equals key times integral f of x dx, okay? So by using these two properties, we can evaluate this integral. This is integral of the e to power x dx minus integral of the 5 over x dx. So integral of the e to power x dx from the first equal red written part from right side equals e to power x plus c, okay, minus 5 times integral 1 over x dx. In the future, we will let the constant term end of the calculation. I will explain why. So this equals e to power x plus c minus this calculation, I use the second properties. I wrote the constant term outside of the integral and integral of the 1 over x from here ln absolute value of x. So minus 5 times ln absolute value of the x plus c. As you see, there are two c. Maybe because of this minus 5 factor, you can say this is minus c. That does not matter. But these c are different, okay? So if this is c1, this is c1, this is c2. So altogether, c1 plus c2 can be considered as a new constant term c. So e to power x minus 5 ln absolute value of the x plus c. So as a result, generally we add these c terms end of the calculation. If there's integral notation, we don't add the c terms here, but there is no, if there is no integral notation, we should write the c terms, okay?